Hello, welcome to Practical RF Design with Keysight ADS tutorial series number 5. In this tutorial today, we will be studying the simulation of a planar inverted RF antenna. Planar inverted RF antenna or PIFA antenna is popular antenna and widely used in a portable and wearable devices such as smartphones and smartwatches due to the small size characteristics. The agenda for today starts with importing PIFA antenna layout and SMD components footprint into ADS. For all my previous videos, I will only be importing the layout of the PCB. For the first time in this tutorial, I will be importing PCB layout together with SMD components footprint. Next, we will be doing EM simulation for the PIFA antenna layout using RF Pro. Finally, we will be doing EM circuit core simulation for the antenna and check return loss, gain and antenna efficiency. This is a 4-layer Ultium PCB with a PIFA antenna for a Wi-Fi module. The PIFA antenna is located here and this is the matching component of the PIFA antenna. First, we will be exporting the layout in the ODB++ file format. In order to do that, go to File, Fabrication Outputs and click ODB++ Files. Make sure all the relevant PCB layers are selected. After selecting the layers, click OK. Currently, the Ultium Designer is generating the ODB++ file. This is the ODB++ file we have just generated. Now, create a folder and copy all these ODB++ files into the folder. I'm going to name this folder as PIFA. We're going to copy this file into ADS Workspace. Next, let's create a new workspace for this project. We name the workspace as PIFA. Now, we will be importing the ODB++ file into Keysight ADS. In order to do that, go to File, Import Design and select ODB++ directory format and click Browse. Paste the copied ODB++ file here. And browse into the ODB++ file and select folder. Under the ODB++ options tab and hierarchy, check the create components in folder option. This option will enable import of SMD components footprint into ADS. Under the Layers tab, select appropriate layers. Under the NATs tab, there are a lot of NATs available. However, for our simulation, only few relevant NATs are needed. So, click Deselect All and manually select NATs required for the simulation. The NATs required for the simulations are the NATs of the matching components and the antenna. I have selected all the required NATs. The next tab is components. Deselect all the components and select only the required components. We have completed the component selection. Now we have to click OK and OK again. A new library in the name of ODB will be created for this import. Click OK for it. This is the layer stack up of the ODB++ file. After making sure all the parameters are correct, we can click OK. The import has been completed. This is the imported layout. The PIFA antenna, the whole PCB, the antenna matching components, and the components footprint have been imported. The components footprint can be found in this folder. We will place AVX component models onto this components footprint and simulate them as the circuit components in the RF Pro. As a next step, we need to install the AVX component library in ADS. To do that, go to Design Kits and click on Manage Favorite Design Kits. I have installed the AVX components library, as you can see here. This component library is free of charge and available on the AVX website together with the installation guide. Since I have installed the AVX component library, I need to enable it in the current workspace. Next, we have to place AVX component models onto the layout. In order to do that, we have to copy the AVX component model to the same library as the layout. Navigate to the Read Only Libraries AVX RF Components and select appropriate components. We will be copying AVX 0402 capacitor and 0402 inductor. Right click on the components you want to copy and click Copy Cell. Next, select the library you want to copy the cell. This library has to be the library of the layout, which is ODB. Do the same to copy the AVX inductor. The AVX components are copied to the ODB library. The next step is to define the layer of the AVX components. Select the component pad and pins, go to Properties and define the layer as a top or con layer. Do the same for the AVX inductor. We are ready to place the components onto the layout now. Place AVX capacitor onto the capacitor pad. Next, place the AVX inductor onto inductor pad. To place the resistor component, go to Lumped with Artwork under the Parts. Select R Pad 1 and place it. Edit the parameters to match the 0402 component footprint and drag and drop the component onto the component pad. We have placed all the components onto the component pad. Next, we have to create input port for the antenna simulation. To do that, we have to place both positive pin and negative pin in the layout. Open the port editor and reference the positive pin to the negative pin to create the port. After that, launch RF Pro. To launch RF Pro, go to Tools RF Pro and click New. Delete user-defined EM analysis because we won't be using it. As a first step in the RF Pro, drag all the pins to the ports. check if the pod is created as intended. Under the Components tab, AVX components and the resistor are shown. We are going to change the role of this component to the circuit and drag and drop to the full EM analysis. When we do that, RF Pro will identify these components as circuit components. These components will be available in the test bench, which will be created after the simulation, and we will be able to optimize these components to meet the design goals. The advantage of this method is we don't have to connect these components in the schematic simulation. Connecting components in the layout upfront will help to avoid errors in the schematic simulation for complex simulation with many components. Next, click Options and set the simulation frequency points. Since it's an ISM band antenna, we will simulate the antenna from 1 GHz to 4 GHz. We are interested in checking far field results at 2.4 GHz, 2.45 GHz, and 2.5 GHz, the low, mid, and high frequency of the ISM band. So these frequencies will be included as a single point. Under the field storage, select user defined frequency and enable far field angular resolution to 5 degrees. Under the simulator tab, we will be selecting momentum microwave simulator. We leave it to the default setting on the mesh density, which is 20 cells per wavelength. Click run to run the simulation. The simulation has been completed. Let's generate the test bench from the results. This is the test bench. We can see the circuit components which we include in the RF Pro here. Let's simulate this and check the S1 mode. To do that, change the frequency settings in the S parameter simulation controller. After that, delete the template. Let's simulate the design now. We got an undefined model error for the AVX capacitor. This is because we need to place the AVX component library definition file, and also because we copied the AVX components out of the AVX RF component library. To fix this issue, we have to place the AVX component library definition file in the schematic first, then swap the AVX components with the same AVX components in the AVX RF component library instead of ODB library. Do the same for the AVX inductor. Change the resistor value to 0 ohm. Now we can simulate the circuit again. S11 plot shows the antenna resonance shifted to the left. We can optimize it back to the 2.45 GHz via matching components. After optimization, a good result of less than minus 14 dB of return loss is achieved across the ISM band. To check the far field parameters, select the center frequency under the setup in the RF Pro, which is 2.45 GHz. Select the results type as gain. Change the excitation to circuit excitation and select the correct data set. The peak gain of 2.56 dBi is achieved by the antenna. This is the radiation pattern of the antenna. Under the statistics, you can see the total efficiency of the antenna. The total efficiency is 84.5%, which is excellent. Thank you for watching this tutorial. See you next time.